Hi, I'm Kevin, and in this quick Power BI tutorial for beginners, you'll learn all the essentials. We'll cover how to import data, build your first report, and share it with others, even if you've never used Power BI before. Let's dive in. To get started, we'll need to install Power BI Desktop. It's free and gives you everything you need to build reports from scratch. Head over to the Microsoft Store app that comes pre-installed with Windows, and in the search bar at the top, type in Power BI. You'll see two different options. We have Power BI Desktop. This is the one that you want. It lets you import data, build dashboards, and publish reports. Then there's also the Power BI Report Builder, but that's more specialized and limited in features. Click on Power BI Desktop and then choose Install or Open if you already have it installed. When you first launch Power BI Desktop, you'll see this home screen. Right up on top, you can start from a blank report or connect to common data sources like OneLake, Excel, SQL Server, and also others. You could even pull in sample data if you just want to explore. Under Recommended, you'll see some helpful learning content. If you've worked on reports before, they'll show up under Recent. Right up on top, let's click on Blank Report to begin. This drops us into the report view. Right here in the center of the screen, you'll see some of the most popular data sources. You can also head up to the top ribbon to access even more options. Power BI lets you pull in data from just about anywhere, Excel, SQL, cloud services, you name it. For this tutorial, I've got some cookie sales and customer data in an Excel workbook that I'd like to analyze. Right up on top, I'll click on this button and there I see my data. If you'd like to follow along, there's a link to the sample Excel file in the description below. I'll double click on this. Once you open your data, you'll see the Navigator window appear. This shows you all of the different tables and sheets in your Excel file. It also gives you the chance to preview the data inside. I'd like to bring in both of these sheets, so over here, I'll make sure to check both of these boxes. Down in the bottom right-hand corner, we have two different options, Load and also Transform Data. If you click on Load, Power BI will bring in the data exactly as it appears in the Excel file. No changes, just a straight import. But over here, if you click on Transform Data, you'll open something called the Power Query Editor. This lets you clean and shape your data before it even reaches your report. For example, you can fix inconsistent values, remove columns you don't need, or even split and merge fields. In this case, we're going to click on Transform Data. That way we can look at how you could quickly clean things up before we start building our dashboard. Keep in mind, you can always transform the data later as well. I'll click here. In this video, I partnered with DataCamp to give you a high-level overview to get you started with Power BI. But if you're serious about learning Power BI, I highly recommend DataCamp's Power BI Fundamentals track. It's perfect for beginners, walking you through everything from connecting and cleaning your data to building interactive dashboards. Just like we're doing today, but with real data sets and hands-on exercises so you could practice in your browser. And if you want to take your skills even further, the data analyst in Power BI track is designed to get you job ready. It covers advanced topics like data modeling and business case studies. And here's the best part. DataCamp partnered directly with Microsoft. So when you complete the track, you'll get 50% off the official Microsoft Power BI Data Analyst Certification Exam. So you're not just learning, you're gaining practical experience and working toward an industry-recognized certification. You'll find links to both tracks pinned in the comment right down below. This drops us into the Power Query Editor. Over on the left-hand side, you'll see a list of queries. Each one represents a table from our Excel file. In this case, we have customers and orders. Right now, I'm looking at the orders table. And across the top, you can see all the different columns. Let's clean this up a little bit. I don't need the rush shipment column for this analysis. To remove it, simply right-click on it, and in this menu, we have the option to remove. I'll select that, and look at that, it's all gone. Just a quick note, when we remove a column here in Power BI, we're not deleting it from the original Excel file. We're just choosing not to bring it into Power BI. Your source data stays completely untouched. Next, it's a good idea to check that the data types look correct. Power BI usually does a great job guessing, but it makes sense to verify. Let's take an example. Here I have the order date. You can see the data type by looking at this small icon next to the column names. If anything looks off, just click on this icon and then you can choose the correct data type from this dropdown. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see a pane called Applied Steps. This keeps track of every change you make, kind of like a history of all of your transformations. If you ever need to undo something or see what you've done, this is the place to look. As an example, if I want to bring that column back over here, I can click on this icon and there I see rush shipments again, but I actually don't need it, so let's remove it once more. Now that everything looks good, let's go ahead and apply these changes. In the top left-hand corner, let's click on Close and Apply. I almost forgot, we didn't even clean the customer data. No worries, you don't have to start over. On the Home tab, right in the center, you see the option to jump right back into the Power Query Editor with Transform Data. Let's click here. Over on the left-hand side, let's make sure to click into Customers. Now, you might notice something important. The first row of our data isn't showing up as column headers. That happens sometimes when Power BI doesn't automatically detect the headers in your file. To fix that, simply click on this icon, and here we can use the first row as headers. Much better. Now, here's a common issue. Under the country column, we've got some inconsistencies. You can see that some of them say United States and others say US. That might not seem like a big deal, but if we try to group or filter by country, it'll treat these as two separate values. Let's fix that. Right up above, let's right-click on the country, and here we see the option to replace values. Click on that. In this window, for the value to find, I'll type in US, and I want to replace it with United States. Then, down in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on OK. Just like that, we've now standardized all of those entries, and Power BI will treat them as the same country. Over on the right-hand side, you can now see the change under Applied Steps. This means that it'll automatically apply the next time we refresh our data. Now that we're all done transforming our data, in the top left-hand corner, let's click on Close and Apply, and that'll bring us back to the Report view. Let's now switch over to the Data Model view over on the left-hand side. I'll click here. Here, you'll see all the different data tables that we imported, along with any relationships that Power BI detected between them. In this case, Power BI automatically identified the relationship between our customers and orders tables through the customer ID field, which is a common field between these tables. The relationship makes sense. Each customer can have multiple orders. If Power BI hadn't detected that link, no problem. You can simply drag the customer ID from one table to the other to create a relationship manually. And then you can simply specify the relationship. I'll click on cancel. Now that our model is all set up, we're ready to start building our report. Over on the left-hand side, let's click back into the report view. This is where the magic happens. You'll see a blank canvas in the center, and over on the right-hand side, we have two key panes. First up, we have data, or all of the different fields. This is where your data lives. If I expand these different categories, you'll probably recognize all of these different column headers. Right next to that, we have visualizations. This is where you choose how to display that data. Let's start by building our first visual. I'd like to see how many cookies we've shipped over time, and I think a line chart will be perfect for this. In the visualizations pane, here we have the line chart icon. Let's press on that, and that inserts a placeholder on the canvas. Now we just need to add data to it. Over on the right-hand side, we have all of our data. Let's start by pressing and holding on the order date and drag that over to the x-axis. Next, let's go up to cookies shipped, press and hold, and let's drag that down to the y-axis. And just like that, we've got a visual showing our cookie shipments over time. You can resize this chart by dragging the corners. Here I can make it larger, or we can make it smaller. I could also reposition it on the canvas, wherever I would like. You can also drill up or down in the hierarchy. Currently, it's showing me the data by year. But over here, we could drill all the way down to cookie shipments by day. Next, let's show total revenue using a card visual. Click the blank space on the canvas, then over on the right-hand side in the data pane, check the box next to revenue. Power BI will insert a chart automatically, but we need to change it. With the visual selected, go to the visualizations pane, and right here, let's click on the card icon. Now, we've got a nice bold number showing the total revenue. I don't know about you, but Mama always said there is money in the cookie business. Let's now add one more visual, a table that shows our customer names. Select an empty spot on the canvas. Then, over on the right-hand side under data, let's check the box next to customer name. Power BI automatically adds a table. What's really cool is these visuals are interactive. We could click on any customer in this table. Let's select this first one, Abbott. You'll notice that the line chart and the revenue card automatically update to show the data just for that customer. You could even press the control key if you'd like to select multiple customers. To clear the filter, simply click in a blank area, and there we're back to the overall aggregate data. That's the power of connected data. It all flows together seamlessly. Of course, you can continue refining your dashboard, add more visuals, apply filters, or even customize the formatting. But this gives you the essentials to start building a fully interactive Power BI dashboard. When you're ready to share your report, on the top ribbon, click on the Publish icon. Right down below, let's save the changes. Here, let's give the file a name, and then down below, click on Save again. Next, you can choose your workspace. I'll select my workspace and then click on Select. Now it's uploading to the Power BI service. And look at that, it's been successfully published. Let's click on this. This drops us into the Power BI service, and we could do a few different things here. In the top left-hand corner, we could click on the File menu, and you can embed this report directly on a SharePoint website or even just on a website. Right up on top, you could also export this into, say, Microsoft Excel, PowerPoint, PDF, and you could even share this directly in Microsoft Teams or via an email. It really makes collaboration easy. And that's it. You just imported and cleaned data, built your first interactive dashboard, and shared it with the world. If you want to take your Power BI skills to the next level with hands-on practice, be sure to check out DataCamp's tracks below. Plus, that 50% discount on Microsoft's official certification. And if you want to see a big sales spike in these reports in the future, just remember to order a cookie from the Kevin Cookie Company. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you found this helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.